Welcome to session 2 of our lesson. We are discussing a case of a tall plant being crossed with a short plant. So there are two varieties, as we talked of homozygous tall, heterozygous, and the dwarf variety is actually existing. So if any of those prints, if you are to cross these two, and then one of the young ones happens to be a dwarf or short variety, then it means that the tall parents had an allele for dwarfness. In that case, we are likely to have an heterozygous case. But if none of the offsprings actually is a dwarf, then it's most certain that we have an homozygous case in which that the parents have that tall gene for that tallness. However, unless there are large numbers of the young ones, this could also be could happen if the parent is actually heterozygous. But by chance, just by chance, none of the gametes carrying the excessive allele was successful in fertilization. So basically, when you cross a tall variety and a short variety, you are likely to have any of those scenarios that we've just explained. But bear in mind, you need to be able to determine the possible genotypes that we have. The T for homozygous case, T dominant, that's the upper case T. That one is heterozygous, the upper case T and lower case T for the heterozygous variety. And then in the dominant case, you know, in the recessive form, we have the lower case T, okay, being homozygous, but they are recessive. Essentially here, if I may expound, all we are saying is that if we have a dominant, for example that, and then we cross with that, this is the parental genotype. You would have the gametes separating in that manner, that, these are the gametes, where you would have a random chance. Assuming this one was the father and this one was the mother, these are the parental, okay, the genotype. Then you would have this random chance combining with that. You would also have that combining with that to give us T. Then you would have this with that to give us T. And then the other possibility would be this combining with that. So you would have a case of that. These are the genotypes where this one be tall, this would also be tall, this would also be tall, this one would be a dwarf. So this is then the phenotype of the young ones that you have. I want us to watch a clip now summarizing most of these basic test cross that we are performing to be able to actually determine the final outcome. Now let's watch the clip and then we'll be able to summarize our lesson by looking at a few things that we are going to actually go through. The clip is actually based on the test cross and all the possible outcomes that we are likely to experience in this.
So let's suppose that you are given a plant, and the only piece of information you have about the plant is the phenotype of that plant, so you know that the plant is tall. Now, we don't actually know what the genotype of that plant is. And the question we want to ask ourselves is, what experiment can we conduct with this plant that we are given that will help us determine exactly what the genotype of that plant is with the tall phenotype? Now, the first question we want to ask ourselves, what are all the possibilities for a genotype that will produce a tall phenotype? So we know there are two possibilities. It's either heterozygous tall or it's homozygous dominant tall. So what that means is the phenotype is either uppercase T, lowercase T, in which case this is the heterozygous tall plant, or it can also be homozygous is dominant, uppercase T, both of these genotypes will produce a tall phenotype. Now, lowercase t will not produce a tall phenotype, it will produce a short phenotype, and that is precisely why we can basically cross this one out. So now we can narrow it down to one of these two cases. Now, we still don't know exactly which one it is. It can be either this or it can be this. The question is now, what experiment can we actually conduct with this plant to determine if the genotype is this or this? Well, if we take this plant with the unknown genotype and we cross it with a plant whose genotype we actually know, then we can figure this problem out. And the only type of plant whose genotype we know for certain is a homozygous recessive, so a short plant. Because the only time a plant will be short is if its genotype is actually lowercase t. And this is what we call a test cross. A test cross is this experiment that basically allows us to determine which one of these genotypes it actually is. So by crossing our unknown genotype with the known genotype, we can determine what that initial genotype is. So let's actually see how that works. Now, let's begin by assuming that the genotype of my unknown plant is this. Okay, so we begin by assuming the genotype is this, and now we want to basically carry out the Punnett square experiment. We want to cross our alleles between this genotype and this genotype here. So let's suppose this column are the alleles that came from this parent. So we have uppercase T, lowercase t. Remember, the law of segregation tells us that during the process of meiosis, when we actually form the sex cells that are gametes, we have the separation of these homologous chromosomes, and so the separation of these two genes, these two alleles. So we have uppercase T goes into this gamete, and we have the lowercase t goes into this gamete, and the same thing is true for our genotype T, lowercase t. Now we actually cross them. So if this sex cell combines with this sex cell, they form a zygote, that will be uppercase T, lowercase t. So we have uppercase T and we have lowercase t. Now, what about if this crosses with this? So once again, we have the same exact situation. We have an uppercase T combined with a lowercase t, and this will be the genotype of our zygote. Or we can have this and this. So in this case, it's T mixing with T. So now we have lowercase t, and lowercase t, lowercase t. So these are the potential genotypes, the possibilities of the genotype for the offspring if the genotype of this plant is uppercase T, lowercase T. So each one of these squares, and we have four squares, so four squares is 100, and each one of these four squares is 25%. So the likelihood of it happening is 25%. So that means 25 plus 25, so 50% of the offspring will be heterozygous tall. So heterozygous, and the phenotype will be tall. The other 50%, so 25 plus 25, will be lowercase t, which is homozygous recessive. And in this case, it will produce short. Now, let's leave this for now, and let's go to this case. Let's now suppose that the genotype of that plant is actually homozygous dominant. So uppercase T. If this is the case, then we have to conduct the same experiment here. Because remember, in the beginning, we don't know which one it is, so that's why we want to carry out two of these Punnett square experiments. So we have uppercase T, And then we have, once again, lowercase t, because we know the genotype of this short plant is in our test cross. And we do the same exact experiment. So lowercase t produces an uppercase T, lowercase t zygote. Here we have the same case, uppercase T mixing with that lowercase t, we produce the same exact zygote as here, and if we carry out these experiments here, we basically get the same exact case. So uppercase T, lowercase t, and uppercase T, lowercase t. So, unlike in this case, we have 100% of the offspring. So the offspring will always be heterozygous. And so what that means is we have 100% heterozygous and heterozygous, and the phenotype will always be tall. So these are the two possibilities. If it's this, then we'll get these offspring, but if it's this, we'll get this distribution of our offspring. So let's suppose I take the test, I conduct this experiment, let's say 1,000 times. Now, if I conducted 1,000 times, and about 500 of the offspring are tall, and 500 of the offspring are short, then I know that the genotype of my initial plant was in fact heterozygous, because only a heterozygous genotype will produce the short offspring. We'll never see short offspring in this distribution here. So let's...
That brings us now to the end of our session. I leave you some questions. The activity to be taken. First question is, if a normal cell has 46 chromosomes, how many chromosomes are present? That, and then the last question.